Was the team just not psyched for this game?
Aaron, I don't understand the question.
Well, I didn't have the privilege of recruiting Dan or watching him play, but from second-hand information, he had a deadly two-hand jump set shot that got everybody excited.
Ooh, what a great basketball player you were, just to have the coach talk about you that way. But I know how much you love football. Not playing, you never could do that, but you love to come out here to Vanderbilt Stadium on Saturdays and watch the Commodores play football, kind of the highlight of your week, I guess. But you know how long you've been around this town?
I don't know if you realize how old you are if you started when I was a sophomore in college. Now, that's a long time ago. But from me and Vanderbilt, good luck to you. What Los Angeles is getting, Nashville's losing.
That was awfully nice of Watson to say, and you deserve it. And that's why I want to take my opportunity to thank you right now. Thank you for being a friend. I was going to do it sitting there next to you, but that might seem a little syrupy, and I know you're a little self-conscious about that, and I probably would be too. But it was 12 years ago this week that I came to Nashville and worked at then WSM-TV. 12 years ago, you invited me to your house to let me do your lawn and be your gardener, and I have been faithful ever since. Well, I'm going to miss you. You've been an awfully good friend. You have given me honest advice, and I will always appreciate that. You've shown me that the best thing in the world to do is to try to be yourself, and you've set an example of that yourself as well.
And these burn are surely, truly happy tears. You know what I mean?
Very nice, very nice.
I've got some little things for you, but I'll save them till the end. We'll give you some of that.
Thanks, Rudy. That means a lot to me. We'll be back after this.
Dan Miller, and one of those is Channel 4's media critic, Ed Kimbrell.
There is no longer any doubt that news anchors become part of our lives. They're the ones who hold shows together. They're the ones who tell us of the good and bad news of every given day. They're often so much a part of our lives that we talk of them as friends. We even start our conversations with the anchor's name, indicating that we heard the story from a good source. Thus, when anchors leave, it sometimes sets off ripples of concern and interest. The departure of Dan Miller from this station set off waves. For 15 years, he's been the best of the best, keeping a balance of humor and seriousness harder to accomplish than most of us realize. His respect for reporters and colleagues has been obvious. Dan Miller seems to have learned long ago that the news business is a team effort. He never abused that team. He teased them. He'd make them laugh, even at themselves. But he did not seek to offend any of us, viewers or team members. His departure to KCBS television, the legendary big time of Los Angeles, is overdue. His fans have been saying for years that he should leave Nashville for the bigger lights and better pay of the major markets. His staying so long surprised many, delighted most. There are others in this market who are part of our lives, anchors like Ann Holt and Chris Clark. They are respected professionals doing a solid job of reporting and delivering that ephemeral beast called news. I think we've become spoiled by the high level of professionalism. The nightly news packages are really a kind of modern miracle, presented to us so smoothly, we take them for granted. Only a jolt like Dan Miller's decision brings us from our expectation that each night we will get the news we need to better understand our part of the world. We will miss Dan Miller. Colleagues and competitors alike respect him. Somehow, for a while, it will not be the same. I'm Ed Kimbrell.
Tonight on Talkback, several viewers expressed their feelings about Dan. Here's Sharon Puckett.
Mrs. Beverly Roy of Mount Juliet said she's sad to see Dan leave. She writes Talkback. Although I don't know him personally, nor have I ever met him, he certainly is a part of my family. He has become, during the past 15 years, a newsman whom you could trust in, believe in, and depend upon to deliver the best newscast anywhere. He is a true legend. Caroline Gardner said she is terribly upset to see Dan go. She writes, "It is the end of an era. Outwardly, the tears do not come, but inwardly, I am wrenched. There is a void. Dan Miller is the composite of the supreme gifted orator. His easiness on the eyes only accentuated his greatness. His grace, his finesse, his cool under pressure, his courtesy, his unbelievable good looks, his distinguishing tallness, every attribute he possesses make him the consummate broadcaster." And Barbara Baggett of Springfield said she's sad that Dan will soon leave. She writes, "I wish there was something that could be done to get him to stay, but if he feels this is the time in his life he needs to make a change, then all I can say is good luck to him, and I hope he will be happy. I know that I speak for many folks who watch and love Channel 4. The opinions expressed in letters used on Talkback in this case do represent the feelings of the management of Channel 4. I'm Sharon Puckett. Is it 17 years? 17?
Almost. Come November would be.
Okay. One of the good things about sticking around that long is you don't have to endure things like this.
That's right.
We're about to do something here. When it was first announced that you would be leaving Channel 4, you know, the phones were ringing, the letters came pouring in. It seemed like the entire city wanted to say goodbye. We couldn't get to all of you, but we did reach a few of Dan's friends and fans.
Good evening. Federal prosecutors ask an appeals judge today to deny Ray Blanton's request for a new trial.
He's been part of Nashville's dinner hour for nearly 17 years. He may just be the most popular man in the Mid-South.
Who's Dan Miller? Seriously, who's Dan Miller?
He's probably running for some kind of city office.
No.
He's certainly not the mayor of the city.
No.
I have no idea.
Bill Hall is coming. Any minute now with the weather on a beautiful day.
Thank you, Daniel.
Those who know Dan Miller love him like a member of the family. For some, saying goodbye can be difficult.
Oh, no. I can't believe it. I love to hear the news from here.
I watched him when I was this high. I'm going to miss him.
It's the worst thing that has ever happened to TV.
He's a tradition here in Nashville.
Oh, we love him. What else can I say?
In his 17 years on the scene at 6, Dan has seldom been at a loss for words. But even Nashville's top anchor man could be caught off guard. One night it started with an impromptu weather script.
Miss Patrick, anything particular you'd like to talk about tonight?
You know, we talked earlier that we didn't know what we were going to talk about. The weather had been a little dull. Nice, but quiet. And I did something. This is legitimate, folks. I wrote a script for us. You just
this
read...
It's all scripted.
You've not seen this, right?
No, I haven't.
You just read parts marked Dan.
Is this clean? I mean,
come on.
I need this on the air. Cool.
Well, I'd be careful. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Well, where's Boyce tonight, Pat?
He's taking the day off today, Dan, but he'll be back tomorrow.
Well, it's great having you here. You're one of the most talented broadcasters in the country, and you're a real asset to this show.
Gosh, Dan, you didn't have to say that.
By the way, Pat, what time is your radio show on?
Nice of you to ask, Dan. It's from 2:30 until 5, Monday through Friday, on WSM 650 on your dial.
I personally think it's one of the top radio programs in the country.
Gosh, Dan, you didn't have to say that.
How about the weather?
Excuse me, this is really embarrassing.
Another embarrassing moment involved a pig named Porky.
That remains one of the most talked about stories we have ever had on.
That's understandable.
It's nice to have that on during the dinner hour, too.
A lot of people think it's disgusting.
Well, we get phone calls saying that. A lot of people like it. A lot of people don't like it. But they all comment on it, so we've shown it again after it being kind of shoved away in the back of the cabinet for the last 5 years.
Okay, you've never followed up on Porky again.
Well, we attended his first and second birthday parties. Unfortunately, there was no third birthday party because in 1973, Porky... You know, we knew we wouldn't be able to do this. Porky went on a journey.
A journey?
He went on a journey.
He died.
Yeah, he died.
This is awful. I mean, we're sorry about Porky dying.
That's why we haven't done this story in 5 years, because we knew we wouldn't be able to get through this part.
The price of meat was awful, baby.
No, no, Porky went on a journey to the great smokehouse in the sky. And actually, he died in the living room.
Did he?
Yes, they had to get a piano lift to get him out of the house.
That's sad.
And they buried him in the backyard.
Huh.
So they did not eat Porky. They buried him in the backyard. And I talked with Mrs. Nelson yesterday and asked her if they had gotten another pet pig. No, they don't have another pet pig. Now they have a pet chihuahua.
Dan's been a familiar face not only to news viewers, but those who stay up late on Sunday nights.
He got another show on TV. What is it? What is it? What is it? Dan Miller's show? What is it?
Miller and Company.
Miller and Company. Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Through the years, Miller and Company has brought big names to Nashville with friendly conversations over cups of coffee. Even the big stars couldn't resist a chance to say goodbye.
Well, he's going to L.A., you know. And I'd just like to tell him we're going to miss him for all 2 weeks. He's going to be coming back here in about 2 weeks. No, every time I go to L.A., you know, about the second week I'm out there, I start wanting to kick old ladies or something. But he'll enjoy it, you know, and they're getting the best. He is the best.
Well, I'm sad. I'm sad, but I'm proud for him, because that's what this life is all about. And I can't blame him for taking advantage of the opportunity that comes along. If I were in his shoes, I'd do the same thing. But, of course, we'll miss him very much.
I wish you good luck and Godspeed. I know you'll do those folks a really good job. I'll miss you, Dan.
Oh, one more thing, Dan. You know, people always want to know what folks like yourself and me and other people here in the public are. They want to know what we're like off camera. And seriously, I just want to tell them that when you get out from behind the desk and off television and, you know, just the normal person, that you're just, well, Dan Miller is all heart.
I'm surprised that Dan Miller has escaped the big time this long, because he certainly has the warmth and the believability of a Walter Cronkite. And I'm going to miss him in Nashville, my family and I, because we always would tune in and watch Mr. Dan Miller. I loved his Sunday night show, and I know that you're going to do well. And I'm going to look you up when I get out there, Dan, okay? Good luck there, partner.
You know, Nashville will miss Dan Miller. I'm going to miss Dan Miller. Hi, this is Les Jameson. This is the Scene at Six. Huh? How about that?
I hear that somebody's leaving the station,
yeah.
Senator.
Yes, sir. Mr. Enemy, I hear that Don Miller is leaving.
Who?
Don Miller.
Don Miller?
And I'd like to say peace, prosperity go with you. And don't forget what we say down south. Don't get too friendly with men with earrings. That's California, you know.
Dan, knowing you as I do, and I think I know you pretty well, some of it's good, some of it might be questionable. I've called my good friend Darrell Gates out in L.A., who's the chief of police there, and give him a little bit about your background, and he's going to be on the lookout for you and hopefully give you some guidance out there.
Dan, Sandra and I are really sorry to see you leave Nashville, but we're so proud of you. And as a memento, we have two cups with the Nashville skyline. You gave us two of your, Dan, what's that, Dan something and company? Dan Miller and Company coffee cups when we're on your program. We'd like for you to remember us and to remember Nashville with this beautiful skyline that you had a great part in creating.
Having Dan Miller just leave on a certain night is like telling your five-year-old that you can't have his teddy bear anymore. Just going to take it away that night and never see it again. It would be nicer if we could have the teddy bear taken away a little piece at a time, and maybe the teddy bear or Dan could be there on Tuesdays and then once every couple of weeks or something like that. I wish Dan well. My fondest hope is that Dan will go out to that evil western city and find whatever happened to Floyd Kephart.
Well, Dan, I just want to say goodbye, and I'll miss you. I remember all those days you invited me over to your house to watch tapes of your old newscast. Dan, I hope you do well in Los Angeles. Oh, how I hope you do well in Los Angeles. Good luck, pal.
Good morning, Dan. It is 8 a.m. Do you remember what that feels like? Only your leaving town would get me up at such an hour. I even had to drag my kid out with me. But we figured, what the heck? It's worth it. It's not every day that Dan Miller leaves town. You realize, of course, you're about the only one left in that newsroom that I haven't had a chance to work with. Oh, yeah, I thought about coming over there, but every time the opportunity came up, Bill Hall would call me up and invite me to go hunting. So I figured I'd better stay where I am. But on a very serious note, I wish you all the best, and I'm going to miss you. I'm really going to miss you. And you know the old saying, you can never go home? In your case, Dan, I hope that's true. Good luck.
When I first heard Dan was leaving, my reaction was a selfish one. I felt sad that my friend Dan Miller would no longer be a part of the Channel 4 scene. And then I realized that, Dan, you deserve a better job in a bigger market. Now, I want you to do all of us a big favor, Dan. When you go to the West Coast, please do not tell all those people that a few years ago, you were named as one of the best-dressed men in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm not sure that would help the image of Music City, USA. Now, seriously, we're all glad that you have this opportunity to advance personally, professionally, and financially. You may be sure that we'll follow your career with interest, and we join with thousands of others in wishing for you the very best. You have paid the price. You have a marvelous opportunity. And in my mind, you have all the ability in the world. Good luck to you. Go get them.
Now let's check the weather. Dan Miller. Well, it's been an ideal day for outdoor activities in South Carolina with sunny, warm conditions. However, increasing cloudiness is expected tomorrow, and showers and thundershowers are likely tomorrow night. And I'll have more on that in a moment. Remember that person? Can you believe it? Pat Sajak, who now works at KNBC in Los Angeles, modeling a, is that a clergy shirt? Sells for $36. They want to know how we're going to go for each other's throat. Why don't we arm wrestle right off the bat?
Somebody on my staff suggested that too, that we just do that.
And get it out of the way.
That's right. No more rating books.
What does your daddy do here at WIS-TV? What does he do on television? I'm sure you see him all the time. Does he do weather?
Mm-hmm.
Is he a good weatherman?
On the national weather map, first of all, here in the southeast, high pressure and warm southerly breezes gave us a very pleasant day in the southeast today. And in fact, over all of the eastern seaboard, temperatures reached into the 70s as far north as New York State today. And it's been very nice.
Stephen, what is your favorite food? What do you like to eat best?
Steak.
You like steak. Do you have steak at the house very often? You too, I see.
And now you know I can't smile without you.
I think I should be dead or something, you know?
It feels like that, doesn't it?
I don't know what to say. That's wonderful.
Well, we've put a lot of time into it, and a lot of people just wanted to say... We couldn't even fit all the people that wanted to say goodbye.
Oh, I'm touched. I don't know what else to do.
Okay, and we're going to start with the goodbyes, I guess, with Bill Hall.
Okay, Demetria. Dan, this is just a small memento of your fellow employees here and other people. It's a huge sign that says, "Goodbye, Dan," and it was signed by... I think just about everybody in the newsroom. Right. The lipstick belongs to Merle Purvis.
Yeah, and, I should have known.
But that's just a goodbye. And I think I can best sum things up with a poem, a letter that came in the mail just today. I'll read this. It says, "Our anchorman, I came to town the other day. I turned on TV. I heard a man say, 'Good evening, I'm Dan Miller.' I listened to his news, the good and the bad, then a few comments that made us sad. He spoke of the weather while looking at Bill Hall, of pork and chitlins, and the map on the wall. Bill gave the weather, and now back to Dan. They brought on the commercials and the sportsman. When the news, the weather, and the sports were through, Dan said, 'I've got something to say and do. I'm leaving Channel 4 and Friends for years. I'll miss you all. There were no tears. I'm going out west where the sun shines bright, the sports are good, and the price is right. These comments were made to all of his fans. Good luck and happiness, we say, to tall, handsome Dan.' From Mr. W.G. King of Nashville, Tennessee." And I would like to say that I won't mess things up by getting teary-eyed. I've respected you. Thank I love you. I'll miss you a great deal, and best of luck to you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, Rudy.
Couple of things. A Wheel of Fortune game.
All right. Thanks. A parting gift.
For those, and here.
Oh, yeah.
For your rear, for appropriately scented for Los Angeles.
It'll look good. Okay. Thanks, Rudy.
Can
I say something here very quickly? And I will keep this short. We're about out of time. And I wrote this out because I didn't think I'd be able to think right now. First, I want to thank the people I've worked with and for here in Nashville. Their strength has become my own. And thanks to the city of Nashville, it has welcomed me and become my home. Two of my children were born here, and virtually every close friendship that I cherish was born and nurtured here. And thanks to all the people in this area whose names I don't know, who have been loyal or even casual viewers over the years, you'll be a part of me always. And more than you know, I appreciate the letters and the expressions of support, the good wishes, especially in recent weeks. I'm confident that whoever ends up in this news desk in the future will find the same friendship and support that has meant so much to me. Thanks for everything.